Good morning and happy Samhain. This morning we are remembering those who have passed from our lives, the lessons they taught us, and the gifts they've given us. Today's story captures that feeling. It is called Badger's Parting Gifts. Badger was dependable, reliable, and always ready to lend a helping paw. He was also very old, and he knew almost everything. Badger was so old that he also knew he must die soon. Now, Badger wasn't afraid of death. Dying meant only that he would leave his body behind, and if his body didn't work as well as it used to, Badger wasn't too concerned about that. His only worry was how his friends would feel when he was gone. Hoping to prepare them, Badger had told them that someday soon he would be going down the long tunnel, and he hoped that they wouldn't be too sad when it happened. One day, as Badger was watching Mole and Frog race down the hillside, he felt especially old and tired. He wished more than anything that he could run with them, but he knew his old legs wouldn't let him. He watched Mole and Frog for a long time, enjoying the sight of his friends having a good time. It was late when he arrived home. He wished the moon good night and closed the curtains on the cold world outside. He made his way slowly down to the warm fire that was waiting for him deep underground. He had his supper, and then he sat down at his desk to write a note. When he had finished, he settled down in his rocking chair near the fire. He gently rocked himself to and fro, and soon was fast asleep, having a strange yet wonderful dream like he'd never had before. Much to Badger's surprise, he was running. Ahead of him was a very long tunnel. His legs felt strong and sure as he ran towards it. Badger moved swiftly, running faster and faster through the long passageway until his paws no longer touched the earth. He felt himself turning head over paws, falling and tumbling, but nothing hurt. He felt free. It was as if he had fallen out of his body. The following day, Badger's friends gathered anxiously outside Badger's door. They were worried because he hadn't come out to say good morning as he always did. Fox broke the sad news that Badger was dead and read Badger's note to them. It said simply, "Gone down the long tunnel. Bye-bye, Badger." All the animals had loved Badger, and everyone was very sad. Mole felt especially lost, alone, and unhappy. In bed that night, Mole could think only of Badger. Tears rolled down his velvety nose, soaking the blankets he clung to for comfort. Outside, it began to snow. After a while, the snow covered the countryside, but it didn't conceal the sadness Badger's friends felt. Badger had always been there when anyone needed him. The animals all wondered what they would do now that he was gone. Badger had told them not to be unhappy, but it was hard not to be. As spring drew near, the animals visited each other and talked about when Badger was alive. Frog was an excellent skater. He recalled how Badger had helped him take his very first slippery steps on the ice. Badger had gently guided him across the ice until he had gained enough confidence to glide out on his own. Badger had given Mrs. Rabbit his special recipe for gingerbread and had shown her how to cut out wonderful gingerbread rabbits. As she talked about her first cooking lesson with Badger so long ago, She could almost smell the wonderful fragrance of gingerbread fresh from the oven. Mole was good at using scissors, and he told about the time that Badger had taught him how to cut out a chain of moles from a piece of folded paper. Paper moles had littered the ground that day. Mole remembered the joy he felt when he had finally succeeded in making a complete chain of moles with all the paws joined. Each of the animals had a special memory of Badger, something they had been taught by him that they could now do extremely well. He had given them each a parting gift to treasure always. Using these gifts, they would be able to help each other. As the last of the snow melted, so did the animal's sadness. Whenever Badger's name came up, someone remembered another story that made them all smile. One warm spring day, as Mole was walking on the hillside where he'd last seen Badger, he wanted to thank his friend for his parting gift. "Thank you, Badger," he said softly, believing that Badger would hear him. And somehow, Badger did. We are all connected to those we love who have passed before us, and to all of those who will come after. May we always remember the lessons we've learned and the connections that we cherish. So be it.